State Attorney Jeff Ashton today says the FBI agent who shot and killed a man tied to an unsolved triple murder was justified in doing so. It happened in May of last year. That suspect, Ibragim Todashev, was a former MMA fighter who went sparred with one of the Boston bombing suspects. WESH's Bob Keeling spoke with Ashton this afternoon. And Bob, he makes it clear that this was no rubber stamp.
Yeah, he does, Martha. In fact, he said they clearly went above and beyond the evidence that the FBI gave them, and he used as an example his insistence on doing DNA tests on blood droplets found on a coffee table inside that condo. Turns out the blood came from the FBI agent who ended up firing all 7 shots that morning.
We did not simply rubber stamp what they gave us. That's why this took so long.
State Attorney Jeff Ashton says his office's investigation backs up the story of an unnamed FBI agent and Massachusetts state trooper who claimed triple murder suspect Ibragim Todashev attacked them inside his Orlando condo. So bottom line is, had you seen something that made you think the officers weren't being totally truthful, this could have turned out much different.
Absolutely.
For the first time, Ashton released a photo of a bloody gash to the head the FBI agent suffered when he said Todashev unexpectedly overturned a coffee table upon which he'd begun to write a murder confession. From there, the two officers inside say Todashev ran to the kitchen and armed himself with this metal pole.
The officer, you know, attempted to not use force by ordering him to stop, ordering him to show his hands.
Instead, they say Todashev took a fighting stance and came at the officers. The FBI agent fired 3 to 4 shots. Todashev crouched down, but soon after lunged at the trooper. The agent fired again. Todashev was hit by 7 rounds from the agent's gun. 1 went through the crown of Todashev's skull.
The position that the trooper described in terms of that sort of going down and then taking a low lunge, it's exactly the position that you would have to be in as a standing shooter to get that angle.
Now, the Council on American Islamic Relations has already come out and said that this was an investigation that was very narrow in scope and points out that there were what they call gross civil rights abuses before, during, and after Todashev's interrogation. Coming up all new at 5, some pointed words that Ashton has for FBI leaks and word of a video that was being taken the night of that interrogation. Reporting live outside the state attorney's office, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.